As bad as these plants look, and it looks a little bit like they're dried out, like they didn't get enough water, that's not it. The problem is, we just had a tough winter on them. And sometimes you can aggravate the problem, make it worse, by going out and seeing a plant like this and then just soaking the water to it real heavy. All that's going to do is make it worse. Don't worry about it. Treat them normal. Give them the normal water as you normally would, and they'll be fine. Again, it's not an underwatering, it's a winter problem. This is Jerry Goodspeed with Utah State University Extension, and I'm here at the Ogden Botanical Garden. And this past fall, we had a very traumatic weather experience that a lot of our plants are complaining about right now. In fact, they're really kind of mad, especially some of our conifers and our evergreens. And what we're seeing is a lot of brown needles, and you can see that here. And it almost looks like the plant is dead, and there's a little bit of green inside. Every winter, not every winter, but a lot of winters, these plants are still alive, although they're resting, kind of not in that really deep REM sleep, I guess what you would say, just kind of a dreamy, a little bit of a sleep. And so they're still using moisture, they're still alive a little bit. We'll have really cold spells or really dry winds, different events. This last fall, what we had was a temperature drop from about 65 down to about 5 in 3 days, which these plants, you know, they just don't like that. And I really don't blame them either. So what happens is we get a lot of dieback on some of the newer needles. And that's what's happening here. We're just getting some brown needling. However, if we look at the plant overall, we can still see some green in here. Can you see the green that's still in here? And the real thing that we look for to determine how that plant's gonna do is we'll start looking at the buds, especially in the spring. And that's where we are right now. We're in early May. And we start to look and notice that those green buds are starting to swell and expand. What that means is that this plant's okay. He's a little upset. Okay, he's really mad, but he's still alive. And come a year or two from now, and you can even see it down in here, down in a lot of these new buds that are breaking and a lot of new leaves that are forming. Give this plant till the end of the summer and even into the next year, and you will not even be able to tell that you had this event. This plant isn't dead. And that's what you're looking for, are these nice buds that are starting to break. Now, if you look down here, this is our thread leaf Arbovita. You can see very little green back inside of there, but you do see it. And that's what we're looking for. Now, this one's going to take a lot more to come back, but if you just look really deep in there, you can see a little bit of life. Now, I'm not sure on this case if it's worth keeping or not. We're going to determine that though later on. We're not going to pull it out right now. We're going to wait for a little while and see how it does. Here we have a Deodar Cedar, and they're touchy the way it is, but when we have an event like we had last fall, they're really touchy. And if you came out and you looked at it right now, you'd say, holy cow, that tree's dead. I'm going to pull it out. But don't, because go in deep and start to look at it, and you'll see new little needles coming out. Again, this is just some winter damage. And the needles did get damaged, that's very true. And right now it does not look very attractive. Give it a year, give it 2 years, it'll be right back, you'll love it, it'll be beautiful, no problem. Here we are with some yews. Again, some of them are doing a little bit better than others, and some of these are just plain upset. And you can see that we've got a lot of dieback on here. But again, this is just winter damage. We still have good live wood. Is that you can cut them back and then they'll just come right back out and look normal. Whereas some of our other plants like junipers, it's almost better if you just pull them out. It's kind of a blessing sometimes to have a winter like this with some plants. Not with yews. Yews we like, we'll just go back in, cut out some of this dead. Boom, they'll just green right back up, no problem at all. Here we have a laurel. And a laurel's a little bit different because it's a broadleaf evergreen. And we know that because it doesn't have needles. It has broad leaves. And the broad leaves that were protected inside during the winter, oh, they're doing okay. But these outside leaves, you can see, somebody just torched them. And that's what it looks like. They just died off. Again, they look really poor. And this isn't my favorite plant to begin with. And this is one of the problems we run into with what we call broadleaf evergreens, plants that keep their leaves during the winter. We have a severe winter. In fact, if you look at them wrong, sometimes they do this. However, they're not dead. Sometimes I wish they were, but these aren't. And you know that, simply like we know everything else, we go in and we see some of these green leaves. And believe it or not, this real ugly patch will look semi-better, look semi-good, in about 3 months. So look as good as laurels can look when they recover.